In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this advanced lattice animation. Tab, to go to edit mode. Right click in S to subdivide like this. Shift D to duplicate, and Enter to settle. We'll use that duplicated cube later for another example. Let's create lattice. S to scale. We need to add the simple deform modifier to the lattice. As we can see, it's possible to add a modifier to a lattice object. As usual, let's create a looping animation by setting the end frame to 100, and keyframing 1, 50, and 100 with I as in India. I have created keyframes for frame 25 and 75 with the values of 45 and minus 45 in order to twist the mesh. In Animation tab, go to Channel, Extrapolation Mode, and select Linear Extrapolation Mode. We now have this looping animation. Let's hide this cube, and unhide to the duplicated cube we've hid earlier. I know that animation looked cool, but we can do that without the lattice. The trick was to use the simple deform modifier, but why do we need to use the lattice? That's because the lattice can affect multiple objects at the same time in the affected region. I'll show you what I mean, by creating a rigid body plane with arrayed rigid body cubes. By the way, my Blender crashed while demonstrating this method, because I have used array sets with 15 instances each. I'm thinking that was too much for the program to handle, and I lost everything on my saved file as usual. The next example is going to use just 5 instances for each array. All compress time. I wanted to show what would happen if I dropped the cube while the lattice animation is running, but Blender couldn't handle that. In edit mode, please remember to type P to separate by loose parts, and move the origins to geometry in object mode. I have typed M to put all the instances into one collection. That's one of the advantages of lattice. We can set a lattice and affect any attached objects within. Imagine what would have occurred if the lattice was edited to be spiky and rotating while being twisted. That would create an awesome abstract art scene. In here, I'll add a vortex force field. Please experiment with the force field settings. That looks interesting. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.